Hey guys, thanks for tuning in. I'm in the Pacific Northwest and I'm going to test out a technique that I've seen on Discovery Channel's Dual Survival. In season 5, the episode's called Coastal Catastrophe. So what happens is the guys are stranded on the Pacific coast and Matt uses a bull kelp container to collect some rainwater, and then around the end of the episode, Matt and Joe use these containers to cook their fish in. So I'm just gonna see if I can get a rolling boil on the fire. As you can see here, I'm holding the bull kelp float. So the float is the part of the plant that basically allows the bull kelp to float. Usually it contains carbon monoxide, and when you cut it like this, it can contain, you know, I've read in books up to 3 liters, like these ones. You'll see it's not even like half a liter per float, but it works, it holds water. Just a quick fact for you guys, bull kelp is really an amazing plant. It's a huge seaweed and it has to grow 17 centimeters per day to reach 36 meters in a year. Perfect. Make a hole on both sides. Pass the stick. Put some water. But these have 500 milliliters, so for experimental reasons, I'm gonna see if how much water I put in these. So. This guy contains about 400 milliliters. See, the bigger one contains a lot more water. Perfect. 921. 922. All right, we're 10 minutes in. Trying to make some coals. It's not boiling yet. I'm about 20 minutes in. And it's pretty hot, I can only hold it like 3 seconds. Once I get a good bed of coals, I'm gonna lower them right in the coals. So it's been about 40 minutes and still no boil, but I got some bubbles coming out of that one, like really small bubbles. But you should always carry a boiling container if you're trying to boil like this, you're screwed up. Got some toast on the go. Now my cedar branch is catching on fire.
branch is dying, but it's almost on a boil.
Disaster happened, the branch cut, but it's now almost or boiling. I'm gonna throw it right in the coals and see what happens. The small one is now boiling. It's right into the coals. See if I can get it clear. It's hard to film in the smoke. Ha! It's really boiling. I don't know how it'll look like in the computer, but there's some bubbles. I thought the bigger one would do a better result, but I guess the smaller one worked. We're at 45 minutes. So in that one I had about 200 milliliters, so that's why it's easier to boil. Like the bigger one, it's just too much water in there for the amount of heat I can get from these coals and this wood, and my wood was really wet too, so it's been boiling for about 5 minutes. Gonna let it boil a little bit more, then I'm gonna try to remove all that from the coals. See what the water looks like in there. My bigger one is now boiling too. It's been, we're at an hour. So it took an hour for this one to start boiling, and the other one about 40 or 45 minutes. Right, I'm gonna try to remove these from the fire and see what the water looks like. Perfect. There's lots of steam coming out, that's what you want. So it took 1 hour. So I tasted the water after this, and it was really salty, you know, it grows in salt water, so there's a lot of salt left in the bull kelp. Maybe it'd be good to rinse it out lots with fresh water before you boil your water in it. But it's not the greatest for purifying water. Like, you should always carry a metal container or a water bottle or, you know, a cooking pot. Where this technique would be interesting is for just cooking or like boiling food like fish or seafood. You know, it would give it a good taste. So unfortunately, I don't have time to test this out today, but maybe in the next video. Alright guys, if you liked the video, click the like button below, and always follow local regulations, and whenever you're foraging some wild edibles, make sure you're 100% certain of your identification.